The universe is a very big thing, but exactly how big is big is up for grabs, and in more ways than you think. Join me as we explore what it means that our universe is expanding. So I think it would be a safe bet that between various TV shows, movies, and potentially our channel right here, that you would have heard that the universe is still expanding, despite it being billions of years old. But if you haven't, then we'll explain a little of the basics of what this means. You see, for a long time, the universe was believed to be finite, quite literally. Not unlike how many people thought the Earth was flat and that going to the edge of it would have you fall off into oblivion. The same thoughts were put onto those about the universe as a whole. That there was somewhere out there a finite line where our universe just stopped. So what exactly happened to make people believe that this wasn't the case? A lot of things actually, but at its core, it's about some people realizing that things were moving up there beyond what is the norm. One of the first people to realize this was the legendary astronomer Edwin Hubble, who in 1922 realized that not only is the universe expanding, it's expanding away from Earth, including whole galaxies, moving at a rate that shouldn't technically be possible, but is so for various things, such as massive galaxies. But then a thought came into the minds of scientists. If something is moving away at a certain rate and speed, wouldn't it also mean that they are moving away from an origin point? Meaning that something got them started on their cosmic dash across their stars. This was one of the first times the idea of a Big Bang came to be. And it would help give a lot of answers, but also raise a lot of questions. For those that don't know, the Big Bang Theory, the scientific principle, not the TV show, come on now, is the belief that there was an incredible explosion of energy that came forth out of nowhere, or seemingly nowhere, in the universe. And from that explosion, everything was formed over time. You see, most scientists agree that after everything settled down from the massive explosion that created it, that things began to grow, expand, evolve, and of course change. For example, it may seem logical to an extent that the growth of Earth came rather quickly, but that's not the case. Earth took billions of years, according to scientists, to get just the most basic of life made, and then it took billions of years more to get to where we are now. The same goes for the rest of the universe, because while it may seem easy to think that everything just settled down after the big explosion that created everything, that's not likely. The edge of the universe likely shifted quite a bit before settling down, if it ever settled down at all, given that the universe could be theoretically infinite, and is almost proven to be infinite as we're discussing now. That's one of the big reasons that scientists try and not just prove the Big Bang, but try and get a lot of information from its potential origin. Because it could prove why the universe is like it is, and why it's expanding like it is. Why do I say that? Well, think of the Big Bang like a bag of marbles. Trust me, this will make sense. So the beginning of the Big Bang, before the explosion, is like the bag of marbles. Everything is compacted, stacked on top of one another, and on and on. Then the Big Bang itself is you releasing the marbles onto the hardwood floor of your house. It's loud, it's powerful, and it goes everywhere. And depending on the size of your floor, it could go on quite a ways. But eventually, it'll stop, right? It's going to lose momentum and wind up in a certain spot. Momentum dies down over time no matter how fast you're going. And it's there that a lot of people have questions about what is going on in the universe. Because if the universe is really billions of years old, and we could see the various galaxies and stars and such are in a certain spot or orbit, even with the movement that the Hubble observed, how is the universe still expanding? It didn't make sense that something was growing when there should have been no residual parts of the Big Bang to push it forward. So what was going on here? The answer that was found, in theory at least, was that the concept of dark energy and dark matter. Scientists believe that dark matter is the reason that galaxies exist as we know them. How does that work when the Big Bang apparently created everything? Simple. While the Big Bang was the creation event, many scientists have noted that galaxies shouldn't stay together in their current forms, meaning they shouldn't rotate in place. Instead, they should just fly apart. But instead, they stay close, most of the times anyway. There are exceptions to that rule, and become formed objects in space. The reason for this is that dark matter has gravity, and scientists feel that because there is so much dark matter in the universe, up to 85% depending on which scientists you talk to, that the gravity exerted allows them to stay as one. The only problem with dark matter is that it's still a theoretical property of the universe. They can't prove it's real, but they do think that it exists in some part, and it is the reason that dark energy exists, which affects the universe in the opposite way of dark matter. Before we get to dark energy and its properties and how it applies to the expansion of the universe, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. That way you don't miss all of our weekly videos. Dark energy is the principle posed by scientists that it's a type of energy that is literally pulling at the universe, thus allowing it to expand. All matter in the universe has a type of gravity, and that holds the universe together. But this dark energy is pulling it apart in a way that counteracts the gravity of the universe without destroying it, which is a good thing, because it'd be the opposite of pulling at something like Play-Doh until eventually it breaks. We currently don't have to worry about that. Dark matter is theorized to be the source of dark energy, not the least of which is because of the whole 85% of the universe may or may not be made up of it. So by that token, dark energy isn't just pushing the universe's boundaries, it's technically doing it in all directions. Furthermore, we don't know if this dark energy is ever going to run out, and due to that, that could mean that the universe is ever expanding, never stopping in terms of its growth, and something that could theoretically never have a single edge to it that we can see. Which is already a problem from where we are on Earth, because the universe is way big and much larger than most people are willing to admit, because they don't understand how big a galaxy can be, or understand the measurements of light years. So let's consider that dark matter and dark energy are real, and they're the reason that the universe is still expanding. What does that mean as a whole? Why does that figure into the accelerated growth of the universe as we know of it right now? Because there are some who still feel that the Big Bang is somehow still a part of everything that is going on right now. But as science has shown, whatever energy or force that the Big Bang created, in terms of a movement wave, would have been dissipated a long time ago, billions of years. But if dark energy was formed via the Big Bang, or via the formation of the universe, and it's been slowly expanding, things that would explain a lot. And let's not forget that the universe is much bigger than we see. What we know of the universe right now is called the observable universe. The observable universe is a spherical region of the universe comprising all matter that can be observed from Earth or its space-based telescopes and exploratory probes at the present time, because electromagnetic radiation from these objects has had time to reach the solar system and Earth since the beginning of the cosmological expansion. Which means that the universe that is growing is beyond what we can see, far beyond in fact. But in that space that is growing and continually growing and growing at an accelerated rate, one has to ask, what exactly is out there? That's kind of the problem. We don't know. And I'm not poking fun at scientists. There are many who feel that the universe isn't just expanding, it's expanding what we refer to as empty space or dead space, where nothing is literally out there, nothing to see, nothing to touch, nothing to experience. But how is that possible? How can the universe be expanding outward when there's nothing to fill it up? This, believe it or not, is one of the questions that pokes holes in the Big Bang theory. Because one of the biggest notions of the theory is that when the explosion of matter and energy happened, it caused an even distribution across the universe as we know it and don't know it. But any astronomy class worth their salt will tell you that's not true. There are plenty of areas in the universe that have far more than others. Not to mention the fact that the only life that has been found so far is on a little speck of rock called Earth. So how is that even distribution? Plus, as noted earlier, the way that galaxies formed is still a mystery because their very existence flies in the face of certain sciences. Not to mention there isn't an even number of galaxies in the universe. Not that we even know them all because many are no doubt outside our purview or just haven't been found yet. So even if all of those galaxies were moving outwards from the center of the universe as Hubble noted and other confirmed, there's little chance that any of them are super closer to the ever-moving edge of the universe. So what lies between them and the edge? And why does the edge keep growing if there's nothing born within it? This is a legitimate problem in the eyes of some scientists because in their minds, that amount of empty space will eventually come to a head. And they feel that either the dark energy will have some kind of reaction and cause the universe harm, or that it could have some other effect that we can't even try and predict. It's not exactly the best situation for scientists to be in, but as time has shown, The ever-growing expansion of the universe seems to be doing us no harm, so far. There's another way of looking at this, though, mainly in what our universe actually is and isn't. You no doubt have heard about the multiverse, right? Probably because of comic books and comic book TV shows and movies, but the principles of them are not lost on scientists. In fact, some actually feel that the expansion of the universe is a type of proof that the multiverse does exist. How does that work? Because if space and theoretically time is infinite, why would it just be constrained to one place? That wouldn't add up in the models of some. So by that token, what we see as the universe might just be one sphere in the whole room full of spheres that have their own form of life, time, and galaxies. Sure, we can't prove it yet, but the theories are out there that support this. Not to mention that many mathematical equations can't fully explain the Big Bang, the expansion of the universe, or just the basic principles of life itself. There's so much still to learn even after billions of years of life in the universe, depending on who you believe. Which brings me to the final point of this topic. Why do we care about the accelerated growth of the universe? After all, there's no way we'll ever reach it, right? Well, you are right on that point. Right now, humanity is very much backwards in how we look at the stars. We can only use things like telescopes, probes, and satellites to observe everything. And even then, we can't even see everything that's within our own solar system. And because we haven't invented warp drives yet, there's no way for us to try and reach the edge of the universe, which by the time we might be able to do such a thing, the universe will have grown so big that we might not even be able to reach it at warp 9. Engage, Mr. Crusher. So why do we care? Because we want to know. We want to understand our universe and everything that goes into it. We want to realize the truth about what made us, what made our solar system and the Milky Way galaxy and on and on. And if we can find out the truth, think about what that would mean for humanity as a whole. We could find proof of things like dark matter and dark energy or another fundamental force that is helping build the universe. It could be the building block of something really new and exciting. All we have to do is figure out what's going on. That shouldn't be too hard, right? Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think of this look at the growth of our universe and how it factors into life as we know it and beyond? Can you believe that the universe is growing at such a rapid rate? What do you think will happen if it continues to grow like this? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.